Develop a link with your maker, develop a link with your parents, and remember, whatever you do or say, always there is Allah who is watchful. And if you are embarrassed about something you've done in your past, quickly delete it and format your hard drive by saying, "Oh Allah, forgive me, I admit my sin, I regret it, and I won't do it again." Four conditions wiped out. In Islam, there is a beautiful teaching, and that is to confess your sin only to your maker. Wow. Imagine if you were to confess your sin to people. May Allah protect us. No, Islam says don't ever do that. That person you might be confessing to may be more deeply involved in sin than you, and you don't even know. I come across very religious perhaps. Only Allah knows what I am swimming in. I try. And subhanallah, I cannot claim to be a perfect human being, not at all. We believe in Islam, none of us are perfect. Kullu bani Adam khata. We are taught by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that all of the children of Adam make mistakes, they make error. And the best of those who make mistakes are those who constantly repent. Mark the word constantly. Constantly repent on a daily basis, every day. I say, "Oh Allah, forgive me, grant me ease, grant me goodness," and so on. So remember this, you can never hide from the Almighty. Quickly, my son, make amends. If you have faltered, ask the Almighty's forgiveness. You're not going to be able to run away from Him. Not be able to run away from the Almighty. So ask Him for forgiveness. And if you really are sincere, Allah says,
إِلَّا مَن تَابَ وَآمَنَ وَعَمِلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا فَأُولَٰئِكَ يُبَدِّلُ اللَّهُ سَيِّئَاتِهِمْ حَسَنَاتٍ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ غَفُورًا رَّحِيمًا.
You know, people who've committed so many various sins, the Almighty says, those who repent sincerely and do good deeds after that, we will reward them in such a big way that we will take the bad deeds they did and convert them into good deeds on the right side of the scale and let them enter into paradise with so many good deeds that were formerly bad. But because they repented and did good deeds after that, we even converted that for them. Who can be more merciful than the Almighty? Like I always say, imagine you owe someone $10,000. And then you say, "You know, I'm very, very sorry. You know, I really can't make it and I won't ever do this again." And they said, "You know what? I forgive the 10,000 and here's another 10. Take it and go." Wow. Is there anyone like that in Singapore? Inshallah, maybe we can say it quickly. Anyone want these riba-free loans, inshallah? It's hard to find someone like that. But the Almighty says, "I will do that for you. I double, triple." In fact, the Almighty tells us, "Do you know whatever you have is actually from me? When you came to the world, you came without anything. And when you leave, you will leave without anything. The only thing that will actually make you or break you, your deeds. Whatever we gave you in between birth and death, you need to convert it into good deeds and take it away. That's all. Because when you leave, you're going to go there just like you were born, without anything. Nobody takes a list of things that they've achieved with them into the grave to say, "You know what, here's all my money, here's everything, here's all my bank cards, here's whatever." No, you could have the most in the world. The winner is he or she who has converted that money into a good deed by spending it in a charitable cause, reaching out to others, doing good deeds, subhanallah, that will help you the day you are gone, as we've spoken.